Good morning, this is Kasturi Day. Today I'm going to discuss the difference between, I'm continuing with that section of the question answer series of reproduction in plants according to ICSE syllabus class 8. Okay. So let me start with self-pollination and cross-pollination. Self-pollination occurs within a flower or between two flowers of the same plant. Or cross-pollination occurs between two flowers of different plants of the same species. In case of self-pollination, no external agent is required for pollination, whereas in cross-pollination, external agents are required for pollination. Okay, like wind, water, insects, birds and animals, etc. Then self-pollination pollen grains are produced in small numbers as there is no wastage of pollen grains. Whereas in cross-pollination, pollen grains are usually produced in large numbers as there are lots of wastage of the pollen grains. Then self-pollination flowers are usually not attractive, whereas cross-pollination flowers are generally attractive to attract the insects, birds, animals, okay, external agents, okay, with the colored petals. Then we come to difference between budding and binary fission. Okay, now budding is an asexual method of reproduction which is shown generally by yeast and also other animals. So it's an yeast is a example of this, where the daughter cells develop in the mode of an outgrowth or a bud from the parent cell by mitosis and unequal cytokinesis. Whereas in binary fission, this is also an asexual method which is shown generally by bacteria, in which the parent cell divides into two identical daughter cells by mitosis and cytokinesis. Then budding, new individual develops on the old individual which remains alive without any change. Whereas in binary fission, the old individual splits into two new individuals. Then budding, a mother cell and a daughter cell results, whereas in binary fission, two daughter cells results. Budding, parent cell is always larger than the newly formed daughter cells, when in binary fission, two daughter cells are similar in size. In budding, cytoplasm of a parent cell divides unevenly, parent cell divides unequally, whereas in binary fission, the cytoplasm of the parent cell divides evenly. And in budding, for certain organisms, it can be done artificially, whereas in binary fission, it's a natural process and it cannot be done artificially. Next, we come to unisexual flowers and bisexual flowers. Unisexual flowers, they have separate flowers, that is male flower and a female flower in two different plants. Okay, flowers having the separate organs. Then bisexual flowers, a single flower containing both the organs, that is male and female reproductive organs, is the same flower. Then unisexual flowers, male flowers contain stamens, whereas female flowers contain pistils. Okay, and in case of bisexual flowers, a single flower contains both the anthers and the ovary, that is stamens and the pistils. Then in case of unisexual flowers, there are two types, monoecious and dioecious. And in case of bisexual flowers, they are also called hermaphrodite or androgynous flowers. Okay, then these unisexual flowers are incomplete flowers, whereas sexual flowers are complete flowers. Bisexual flowers are. In case of unisexual flowers, monoecious flowers undergo self and cross-pollination, whereas in dioecious flowers undergo cross-pollination. Whereas in bisexual flowers can undergo both self and cross-pollination. In case of unisexual flowers, example are papaya, watermelon, corn, etc. Whereas bisexual flowers are lily, hibiscus, etc. Then we come to certain short questions. What is binary fission? Binary fission is a type of asexual reproduction where a unicellular organism divides into two small identical cells, each having the potential to grow to the size of the original cell. Okay, it has each cell which have formed by the division of the parent cell, they have the potential to grow to the size of the original cell, example bacteria. What is rhizome? It is a short branched underground stem having distinct nodes and internodes which bears buds which can grow into new plants like ginger, banana, etc. Then how do plants such as bryophyllum propagate? They propagate asexually through vegetative propagation by leaves, which produces bud at its margin. And when these buds fall to the ground, from these buds, it's the new individual grows. And when these plantlets fall onto the ground, they start forming their new plant. Okay. Then what is tissue culture? Tissue culture is a process of producing plants from tissues of the desired plant in an artificial nutrient medium, which are kept under laboratory conditions in a test tube. Okay, in a test tube, an artificial nutrient medium is kept and in which desired plant's tissues are grown in that. Okay, the plants so produced by this method are keeping them in an artificial nutrient method, would be exactly similar to the mother plant in all aspects. Okay, it is also called micro propagation. Example, orchids, asparagus, etc. Okay. Next, we come to mention the changes that occur in a flower after fertilization. After fertilization, the vegetative parts, that is the petals, the sepals, and the parts which are not, the reproductive parts which are not used, like the stigma, style, all fall off. The ovary swells up to form the fruit, the zygote which divides to form embryo, and the fertilized ovule develops into seed which contains the embryo enclosed in a seed coat. Okay, then how does a spirogyra reproduce? They reproduce by fragmentation. Name the three agents of pollination: wind, water, and insects. What is artificial pollination? It is a process in which pollination does not occur naturally, but is rather influenced by human, but it is done by human, where they carry the pollen of a flower to another flower or allow them to fertilize the flowers. Okay, this technique is used to improve the quality of the crops like disease resistant, high yielding, high nutritional value, taste, color, and flavor. Okay, so to improve these qualities, this artificial pollination is done. Okay, now, let me stop here. I'll continue with the answer of the following questions in detail in my next video. Please go through these. If you have any doubt, please do write in the comment box, or you can also write in the email ID, and you can also give suggestions to improve my video so that you can like it much better. That can help you a lot. And if you like the video, press the like button so that I can produce you some more interesting videos. And if you are a new viewer to my channel or not subscribed yet, please do subscribe to get the notification of my next video. Thank you.